That's La Vista, actually, in the bottom corner. Mm-hmm. You're seeing live shots of the entrance of La Vista. And on top, you're seeing what's happening at the JBC as well.
So 7 months in detention, roughly 7 months in detention, and she has temporary freedom for now after being granted bail by Pasay RTC Judge Jesus Mupas, and after posting a bail of 1 million pesos this morning.
Well, it seems like we have Attorney Raul Lambino on the line to join us right now. Attorney Lambino, are you there?
Yes, I'm here, GG and TG.
Hi, Attorney Lambino, what can you tell us about what's going to happen next?
Well, right now, GG live, the former president has just come out from her hospital detention room, and she has just boarded yung kanyang sasakyan. And after signing all the released order documents that was brought here by the sheriff, so she's now proceeding, her convoy is now proceeding into the chapel of the veterans to pray and say thanks to the Lord, no, for this glorious day for her, no. And then from here, she is proceeding to her house, to La Vista, to stay overnight. And then by tomorrow, she told me that she will be seeking an alternative medicine in a wellness center somewhere in Tagaytay. But starting next week, starting Monday next week, she will be coming back to veterans every day for her continuing medical therapy of at least 1 hour every morning. So this will show that she will still have undertake all these necessary medical procedures for her continuing therapy.
Tell us what it was like inside the VMMC just moments before she walked out of that room. Who was there? What was the mood like? What were people doing? What was happening?
I did not get that question, Gigi. I'm sorry.
Yeah, we want to know what was happening inside the VMMC moments before Mrs. Arroyo walked out of the hospital. Maybe you can help us picture what was going on.
Right now, almost all the vehicles are already moving out of the Veterans Memorial Medical Center on their way to the chapel. And there were some members of Congress who came over, and some members of her family and friends, and some supporters who local officials from Pampanga who came over, and some were quite emotional a while ago when the release order was brought in by the sheriff of Pasay, and they were all happy. Some were in the tears of joy of what happened, and now they have already left the compound, and I'm walking now on the street going towards my car to follow them to the Veterans Chapel. Yun ang situation ngayon dito, Gigi.
Attorney Lambino, TJ Monatok here. Earlier, we were monitoring the tweets of Attorney Ferdinand Topacio. We don't know if you're aware that he was tweeting as much as he could.
He was here a while ago.
Yes. And he was tweeting us some details from what he was observing inside the hospital. He said that there was singing involved. Did you notice the singing that he observed as well? Na meron daw mga kumakanta ng "Please release me, let me go."
I did not hear about that. I don't know if Attorney Topacio maybe have overheard one or two of the supporters of the former president who came over. But I wasn't able to see that a while ago. We had some picture taking a while ago when the former president was signing the release order that was broken, and it was Attorney Topacio's camera or the iPad, I think, that was used in order to take this picture.
Okay. And Attorney Topacio as well mentioned on his Twitter that Congressman Villarosa was there. Siya po ba yung nagdala ng chocolate cake? Meron puro daw cake na idinala ng mga bisita?
I really don't know who brought this cake. Pero meron din ako nakita chocolate cake. I think baka nga si Congresswoman Villarosa, but I'm not quite sure.
Now, Attorney Lambino, there are reports, of course, that are surfacing that Mrs. Arroyo will want to seek medical treatment abroad. What can you tell us about this?
Well, there was no talk about that, and we haven't discussed that for quite some time.